Namaskar, DCE Digital Learning Swagata. In this video, I am going to present you BSc Third Semester Mathematics Algebra Paper 3 Groups. Binary Operation, Definition of a Group and Subgroup. First, let me define binary operation. An operation star defined on a non-empty set G is said to be a binary operation if and only if, for all, A comma B belongs to G implies A star B belongs to G. Here star can be addition, multiplication, subtraction, division or any other mathematical operation. For example, addition and multiplication are binary operations on the set of natural numbers, integers, real numbers and complex numbers. Algebraic structure, a non-empty set G with one or more binary operations on G is called an algebraic structure. Example, the natural numbers with respect to addition is a group and Z with respect to multiplication. Integers with respect to multiplication is also a group and with the two binary operations, addition and multiplication, R, that is a set of real numbers, is also an algebraic structure. Now let us define the group. A non-empty set G together with an operation star is said to be a group if the following axioms are satisfied. The first property, the closure law, for all A comma B belongs to G implies A star B belongs to G. Star here it can be addition, multiplication or any other mathematical operation. See, if you combine the two elements of G together, if that combination, either it is a sum or difference, even it can be a product, if that also exists in G, then we say that G satisfies the closure law. Second, associative law. For all A comma B comma C belongs to G implies that A star bracket B star C is equal to bracket A star B star C. See, the here star can be a binary operation, either it can be, as I said, multiplication or addition. See, for example, if you take addition, if you are adding three numbers, natural numbers together, if you add first B and C, then that sum is added to A, or add A and B and then add that sum to C, the three numbers sum is remains same. So that is called associative law. So symbolically we represent associative law as A comma B comma C belongs to G for all A star B star C is equal to A star B star C. Third property is identity. There exists an element E in G such that A star E is equal to E star A is equal to A for all A belongs to G. See, here when you are operating with an identity element with another element, the product or the sum remains same. For example, 0 is the identity element with respect to addition. When you add 0 to any number, the sum is same number itself. And with respect to multiplication, 1 is the identity element. When you multiply any number with 1, the product is the same number itself. Fourth property, inverse. For every element A in G, there exists an element A inverse in G such that A star A inverse is equal to A inverse star A is equal to E. Means when you operate with the A inverse with the A, the product or the sum is equal to E. For example, with respect to addition, inverse of 2 is minus 2. When you add 2 and minus 2, the identity element with respect to addition is 0. That we get, minus 2 plus 2 is equal to 0. Similarly, with respect to multiplication, for A is equal to 2, A inverse is 1 by 2. The product of 2 and 1 by 2 is equal to 1. That is the identity element with respect to multiplication. See, if these four properties are satisfied by any set G with respect to the binary operation star is called a group. And along with these four properties, If it satisfies the commutative property, that is A star B is equal to B star A, then that group is called as abelian group. For example, with respect to addition, A plus B is equal to B plus A. With respect to multiplication, AB is equal to BA. If this condition is satisfied for all A comma B belongs to G, then that group is called abelian group or commutative group. If these four properties are satisfied, then it is called a group. If along with these four properties, commutative law holds good, then that group is called abelian group. See, suppose if any set with respect to the binary operation satisfies only these two conditions, that is closure law and associative law, then we call it as a semi-group. And along with these associative and closure law, if the identity element exists, then we call that set as monoid. Okay, see, along with the closure law and associative law, if the identity element exists, then that is known as a monoid. If G has finite number of elements, then G is called a finite group. Otherwise, it is called as infinite group. Infinite group means the group has the infinite number of elements. The number of elements in a group is defined as order of a group G, and that is denoted by order of G. Symbolically, we represent order of G like this. So let us discuss about the properties of a group. Identity and inverse elements of a group are unique. That means every group possesses unique identity. Only one identity element will be present in a group. Similarly, inverse element is also unique. Then A inverse whole inverse is equal to A means inverse of an element, and when we take whole inverse, A inverse whole inverse is equal to that element itself. If you take inverse of A twice, then it gives the same element. This is the another property of a group. Then A star B whole inverse is always defined as B inverse star A inverse for all A comma B belongs to G. Left cancellation law. AB is equal to AC implies B is equal to C. Here we have cancelled AA left side, then the equation becomes B is equal to C. Then right cancellation law. AC is equal to BC implies A is equal to B. Here the LHS and RHS we have CC. See, after cancelling them we get A is equal to B, and this is called the right cancellation law. In any group, if A inverse is equal to A, then that group is an abelian group. Abelian group means it has to satisfy the commutative law along with four properties. If G satisfies the commutative law, then it is called abelian. Means if A inverse is equal to A for all A in G, then G is an abelian group. If AB whole square is equal to A square B square for all A comma B in G, then G is also abelian group. Every group of order less than 6 is an abelian group. If G is a group of even order, then there exists an element A such that A is equal to A inverse, or equivalently A square is equal to E. Means if a group has even order, means the number of elements in a group are even, then we say that A is equal to A inverse, and equivalently A square is equal to E. Now let us pass on to the subgroups. Subgroup definition. A non-empty subset H of a group G star is said to be a subgroup of G if and only if H itself is a group with respect to the operation star. That means a non-empty subset H of G is said to be a subgroup of G if H itself is a group with respect to the same binary operation star. A non-empty subset H of a group G is a subgroup of G if and only if it satisfies these two conditions. For all A comma B belongs to H implies that A star B belongs to H. That means the closure law must be satisfied. A non-empty set H we have taken, and let A and B be two arbitrary elements of H. If it implies A star B belongs to H and A belongs to H implies A inverse belongs to H. For every non-zero element must possess an inverse. If any element A you take in H, H must also contain its inverse element. If these two conditions are satisfied, then H is proved as a subgroup of G. By combining these two, we get a non-empty subset H of a group G is a subgroup of G if and only if A, B belongs to H implies A star B inverse belongs to H. See, what does it implies? A star B inverse means the closure property is satisfied, and also this implies that if B is present in H, B inverse also must be there. Okay, so the combined condition for the subgroup is A comma B belongs to H implies A star B inverse belongs to H. Either this condition or these two conditions are satisfied by a subset H, then that is known as a subgroup of G. Every group has at least two subgroups. They are that group and the identity element, which are called as improper subgroup. Other than these two, if it possesses any other subgroup, then that is known as a proper subgroup. That means the group itself and identity are the improper. And other than these two, if it possesses any other subgroup, then that is known as the proper subgroup. Intersection of any two subgroups is again a subgroup, but the union need not be. So, intersection of two subgroups is again a subgroup. Identity and inverse of a subgroup and the group are same. For example, if you take 0 is the additive identity in a group G, then even H will have the 0 as an identity element, and inverse also same in both the subgroup and group. Thank you.